Space Age Asteroid Belt Part 2 in Forge of Empires. I already showed the start into that brand new age in the first episode. The second part starts with something that I already should have put into the first part. Whenever I reach a new age, I use all my 1-up kits and renovation kits to bring my event buildings to the new age. This recommendation is valid for all ages. In lower ages, I usually would not use all of these kits as there are more ages to come soon. At the highest age, it is different. It will take a while until the space age Venus will start. Until then, I will again have collected enough. Therefore, I now use what I have. I also renovated my champion retreat to receive heroes from my Alcatraz immediately. I do not recommend to do the same. In many other ages, this is a good strategy. But in Space Age Asteroid Belt, I'm very unhappy with these champions. Therefore, I'm not very happy to also receive one from the daily challenges. After collecting all productions in the evening, the renovated event buildings already fill my stock of goods comfortably. The quest line does not provide special surprises. The movable abilities that I constructed in part 1 did not help for the quest that came later. I again have to build some more. This isn't a problem. They are not expensive, I have enough space up there, and they fill my stock of credits. Even without a related quest that asked me to collect some asteroid ice, I would do that. The battles to get that ice are not difficult. Just like in Guild Battlegrounds, the computer always attacks rogues first. With what I receive after one battle, I can complete the quest, but it will take very long to build a good stock of it. Compared to what research is asking for, this is very humble. Due to the long scouting times, it takes long until I own more asteroid ice. For a long time, it is not enough to use it for goods productions. Only because quests ask for it, I build goods productions in my outpost, but I don't use them. Currently, all my goods are coming from event buildings. Of course, I advance quickly on the province map. In all battles, the opponent has a 160% bonus on attack and defense. I succeed easily with automated fights using Mars Age units, nearly without losing units. I'm still not very happy with the new units. Most of them have nearly no range, receiving retaliation damage always. This is not compensated by their better properties. I'm not highlighting details of these battles as players in the highest age usually have enough fighting bonuses so that it will not be a challenge. But don't forget that on the province map, rogues are not attacked first. After not having fought on the province map for long, this could be forgotten easily. The second exploration site for the asteroid ice is very disappointing. When conquering more provinces, a third and fourth exploration site will follow, but asteroid ice will be short for a long time. The expenses for scouting are extremely high, but in that age, players usually have so many coins that they don't notice even such amounts. In the research tree, I did not follow a certain plan or concept. I simply researched those technologies for which I had collected a complete set of resources. It is more reacting than acting, mainly concentrating on getting as many resources as possible. On the market, all players want new goods, but nobody offers these. Mars goods, we all have more than enough. there are no important milestones in the tech tree. The new military units are not needed urgently. The only goal is to make progress. The really interesting part still is coming.